Good morning all of you. In this video we discuss how to calculate the goodwill under super profit method. Super profit means the excess of average profit over the normal profit. That is called super profit. What mean by super profit? Super profit means the excess of average profit over the normal profit, that is called super profit. Okay, now how to calculate the goodwill under super profit method. Okay, now what are the steps to calculate the goodwill under super profit method? Okay, first step, average profit is equal to total profit divided by number of years. Normal profit is equal to average capital employed into normal rate of return divided by 100. Normal profit is equal to average capital employed into normal rate of return divided by 100. Super profit, what is the formula? To calculate super profit, average profit minus normal profit. Super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. Okay, now calculate the goodwill. Goodwill is equal to super profit into number of years purchase. This is formula to calculate the goodwill. Okay, now by taking one problem, you can understand how to calculate the goodwill under super profit method. Please subscribe our YouTube channel. Please share this video to your friend circle. Give your like this to video and write your any suggestion, any query and any comment in a comment box given below this video. Okay, now see the problem. What is given in the problem? Average capital employed in the business rupees 2 lakh. The total capital invested in a business how much rupees? 2 lakh. Second, normal rate of return expected in a business is 10%. The owner or the shareholders of the business is expected the normal rate of return on investment. What is the rate of return? What is the normal rate of return expected in a business is 10%. Average profit in a business rupees 50,000. Every year the average profit is rupees 50,000. The value of the goodwill is based on 4 years purchase of the super profit. The value of goodwill is based on the 4 years purchase of super profit. Means one business has to purchase the business of another business, means the actual capital employed in that business, means in purchasing business. What is the capital employed in the business? Rupees 2 lakh. What is the normal rate of return on the investment in such business is 10%. Average profit in a business rupees 50,000. The value of goodwill is based on the 4 years purchase of super profit. Means you have to calculate the super profit of another business, then you have to multiply by 4 years. Okay, now compute the goodwill. Okay, now we start to solve the problem. First one, normal profit is equal to, first you have to calculate normal profit. What is the formula? Average capital employed into normal rate of return divided by 100. normal profit is equal to average capital employed into normal rate of return divided by 100. Okay, now in this problem you have to calculate the normal profit. Okay, what is normal profit in this problem? The actual capital employed in the business rupees 2 lakh. The actual capital employed in this business, how much rupees? 2 lakh. What is the normal rate of return expected in this business? What is the rate of return in this problem? 10%. That's why 10 divided by 100. 2 lakh into 10 divided by 100. What is the amount? Rupees 20,000. This is normal profit. Okay, now how to super profit? What is the formula to calculate super profit? Average profit minus normal profit. Average profit minus normal profit. Okay, now calculate super profit. Super profit is equal to average profit. Already given in the problem, how much rupees? 50,000. What is the average profit? Rupees 50,000. Already given in the problem, average profit 50,000. Minus normal profit. Just have calculated normal profit, how much rupees? 20,000. Just have calculated this one. Rupees 20,000. What is the super profit? 50,000 minus 20,000. What is the answer? 30,000. Rupees 30,000 is a super profit. Okay, now how to calculate the goodwill for this business? Goodwill is equal to, what is the formula? Super profit into number of years purchase. Super profit into number of years purchase. Okay, goodwill is equal to super profit into goodwill is equal to super profit. Just have calculated rupees 30,000. Just have calculated rupees 30,000 into number of years purchase given in this problem. For how many number of years the business wants to purchase the goodwill? 4 years purchase. That's why into 4 years purchase means 30,000 into 4 years. What is the answer? 1,20,000. This is the goodwill, rupees 1,20,000. Means the vendor company, the purchasing company has to pay the rupees 1,20,000 to the vendor company which business is to be purchased by the vendor company. That's why the vendor company, means the purchasing company, has to pay the rupees 1,20,000 as additional amount to the selling company. Rupees 1,20,000, this is the goodwill. Okay, now come to the second problem. Calculate goodwill by purchasing 4 years super profit from the following information. Calculate goodwill by purchasing 4 years super profit from the following information. Okay, now see that what are the information. First one, year profit. Year 2017 profit 7,000. Year 2018 profit 9,000. Year 2019 profit 8,000. Year 2020 profit 8,000. Okay, means for 4 years the profits are different. Means that's why you have to calculate the average profit. Okay, what are the other adjustments? The rate of income tax at 30%. Normal rate of return is 10%. Normal rate of return is 10%. Okay, now third adjustment, the equity share capital rupees 40,000. The equity share capital invested in such business rupees 40,000. Fourth adjustment, reserve fund, how much rupees? 5,000. Reserve fund rupees 5,000. The securities premium or share premium rupees 2,500. The share premium or securities premium rupees 2,500. The dividend fund rupees 1,000. One matter you have to understand, what is that? The equity share capital, reserve fund, premium, dividend fund, all these are owner's fund. Means all these amounts are to be given to the owners. Next one, the goodwill. Already goodwill is there in the business. How much? Rupees 2000. The preliminary expenses rupees 6000. Okay, all these are information. Means first how to calculate the goodwill. Okay, how to calculate the goodwill? First one, how to calculate the average profit. Average profit is equal to, what is the formula? Total profit divided by number of years. Okay. What is the first year profit? 7,000. Second year profit? 9,000. Third year profit? 8,000. Fourth year profit also? 8,000. Divided by 4 years. Why the 4 years is taken? Because the profits information given for 4 years. That's why I divided, now taken 4 years as a denominator. Okay, now, how to calculate average profit? Means, average profit is equal to total profit divided by number of years. Total profit 32,000. Means 7,000 plus 9,000 plus 8,000 plus 8,000 divided by 4 years. Okay, the average profit is equal to, means 32,000 divided by 4 years. Okay, what is the average profit? 8,000. Average profit is equal to 8,000. Okay, you have to deduct the income tax. If there is no information for income tax, it is not necessary to deduct the income tax. But in this problem, he has given the rate of income tax. That's why you have to deduct income tax out of the average profit. Okay, average profit after tax. Okay, what is the average profit? Just have calculated how much rupees? 8,000. Less income tax. What is the rate of income tax? 30% given in the problem. Rate of income tax at 30% given in the problem. Okay, less income tax means 8,000 into 30 divided by 100. What is the income tax amount? 2,400. Okay, after deducting income tax, what is the average profit after tax? Rupees 5,600. After deducting income tax 2,400, what is the average profit after tax? 5,600. Okay, this is the average profit after tax. One thing is noted, what is that? If there is no information regarding income tax, it is not necessary to deduct the income tax. If the income tax is given, if the rate of income tax is given in the problem, definitely have to deduct the income tax out of the average profit. Okay, now continue this problem. Capital employed. Okay, what are the capital employed? Equity share capital, reserve, premium, dividend fund. These are owner's fund. That's why this is capital employed. 40,000. This is the equity share capital. Plus rupees 5,000. This is the reserve fund. This is also owner's fund. Next one, plus securities premium or share premium. How much rupees? 2,500. Plus securities premium rupees 2,500. Plus dividend fund 1,000. This is also owner's fund. Dividend fund rupees 1,000. This is also owner's fund. the total capital employed in the business, how much rupees? 48,500. Okay. But in this problem, he has given us some information. What are those? Goodwill and preliminary expenses. Okay, actually, these are those expenses are to be written up. Means goodwill is also fixed as means intangible assets. Next one, preliminary expenses is a fixed assets means the miscellaneous expenditure. Those expenses are to be deducted. Means at the end of the business, the owner has to bear those expenses. Okay, now how to deduct it? Okay, capital employed is equal to, just you have calculated, what is the answer? 48,500. Out of 48,500, you have to deduct the intangible assets, rupees goodwill, rupees 2000. Okay, you should deduct it, rupees 2000. Minus another one, goodwill rupees 2000, another one rupees 6000. This is also fictitious assets, rupees 6000. Okay, actual capital employed in the business, what is the amount? Rupees 40,500. Okay, now and also you have to deduct the average profit. The average profit means the half of the average profit. You have to deduct the capital employed, because every year the profit is constant. Every year the profit is not constant. That's why you have to deduct the average profit, half of the average profit. That is, you have to treat as the uncertainty. That's why you have to deduct the average profit out of the total capital employed. Means you have got the answer, how much rupees? 40,500 less 5,600 into, what is the average profit? 5,600 into 1 by 2, what is the answer? 2,800. 40,500 minus 5,600 into 1 by 2, what is the answer? 2,500. 5,600 into 1 by 2, what is the answer? 2,800 means a half of the average profit. 40,500 minus 2,800 is equal to 37,700. This is capital employed. Next one. Normal profit. What is the normal profit formula? Capital employed into normal rate of return divided by 100. Normal profit, capital employed into normal rate of return divided by 100. Next one. Normal profit is equal to capital employed. What is the capital employed in the business? Just have calculated. 37,700. Just you have calculated. Normal rate of, capital employed 37,700 into normal rate of return given in this problem. Normal rate of return given in this problem, what is the amount? What is the rate of normal rate of return? 10%. 37,700 into 10 divided by 100. Okay, what is the answer? Normal profit is equal to 3,770. This is a normal profit. 3,770. Okay, next, you have to calculate the super profit. What is the formula to calculate super profit? Now you see that. Average profit minus normal profit. Average profit minus normal profit. Okay, solve it. Super profit is equal to average profit. What is the answer? 5,600. Just have calculated average profit 5,600. Solved, calculated in this problem initial stage. What is the average profit? 5,600 after deduction of income tax. Less normal profit. What is the normal profit? 3,770. Just have calculated. Okay, 5,600 minus normal profit 3,770 What is the super profit? 1830. Is it? Okay, now goodwill is equal to, what is the formula? This is the final objective to solve this problem. What is the final objective to solve this problem? To calculate the goodwill. Okay, goodwill is equal to super profit into number of years purchase. Number of years purchase. Okay, now calculate the goodwill for this problem. Goodwill is equal to super profit. Just have calculated here. Okay, what is the answer? 1830. What is the answer? Just have calculated super profit. 1830 into 4 years. Given in this problem, 4 years. Okay, what is the answer? Goodwill is equal to 7320. Goodwill is equal to 7320. Means, what is the answer for this one? Goodwill is equal to 7320. Thank you for watching this video. Please share this video to your all friend circle, and also don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you one and all again.